It's Jesse, and in this video, I'm gonna tell you guys about how to get on testosterone because I had a friend reach out to me and they wanted to know how they could get on testosterone. And this particular friend does not have insurance, so I'm gonna cover both how you would go about it if you do or do not have insurance. So real quick before we get into it, I just wanna say thank you so much to everybody that has taken the time to just watch these videos alone, but thank you so much for those of you who have liked it or commented or subscribed. I really, really do appreciate it. And I noticed that 67% of my views are coming from people that are not subscribed yet. So if that's you, I'd really, really appreciate it if you could subscribe. You don't have to, but if you do, I'd really appreciate it. But thank you so much to those of you who are subscribed and to those of you who watch. Everybody, thank you to everybody. Now, let's get into it. I wanna say it was like, 2013 or something. I can't remember, but it was a long time ago when I first started looking into this stuff, and there were so many videos out there and so many people that helped me on YouTube. There was Ty Turner, Benton Sorensen, there was Skyler. There were so many people on YouTube back when I started looking into this and trying to figure out my life and everything. Like, there were so many people that helped me out, and I want to be just as helpful. So don't hold me to any of it. I'm not a doctor. I'm not, you know, a trained professional in anything, really. So do your own research and make the decisions that you want to make. This is just my experience and the stuff that I've seen other people experience, just to bring knowledge to friends, family, and all those that need this information. So basically, what I got from what I researched was, more often than not, this is a traditional way of doing things. So what you do is you go to your primary care doctor, you call them up, and you let them know that you want to start hormone replacement therapy. You know, you want to start HRT. And then from there, they're going to refer you to a psychologist. And the psychologist, when you go to see them, they're just trying to help and make sure that you're okay up here to make this type of decision. So after you meet with your psychologist, they will usually refer you to an endocrinologist or give you your T letter saying that, yeah, you're good to go, you know? Or the psychologist will refer you back to your primary, and your primary will then give you a referral for your endocrinologist. The endocrinologist is the person that gives you, they're the ones that are gonna do your blood work and give you your prescription for testosterone. So that's the traditional way of doing it. And then, you know, once you go through those steps, then you get your first shot of testosterone and you're happy. Now, it is important to note that some doctors will require you to live out as male before you start testosterone, just because they want to make sure that starting T is what's right for you at this moment in time. And sometimes if you haven't, you know, been living as male, you know, with your male pronouns and things like that, they'll be a little skeptical of letting you start right away. They just want to make sure that, you know, you're 100% sure, you know, you're putting something foreign into your body, you know, and even if it's going to make you happy now, you don't know what the effects are going to be like down the line. So it's something that you really, really have to think about. Like me, I thought about it for years, and I made sure it was something that I wanted, you know, but everybody's different. But the doctors just want to make sure that it's something that you're sure you want to do, you know, you want to proceed with at this point in time. So that's why they recommend that. Usually your doctor or your psychologist will recommend that if you haven't been living as a male, then you start to do that. You know, socially you come out as male and use your male pronouns and your male name and go from there. So that is the traditional way of going about getting on testosterone. Now, more non-traditional way of doing it is kind of the way I did it, actually. This way, I don't really know what this is called. I did research on it, but I didn't actually find like an actual name for it. But it's just like an at-will, like a self-consented kind of thing. I live here in Indiana, and I drove up to northern Indiana. I drove to Goshen, Indiana, and I went to, I believe it's called New Life Mosaic Health Center or something like that. I went there, and because I'm 24, at the time when I went, I was 23. She basically explained to me that I can go ahead and just, she can prescribe me testosterone because that's something that I want to do, because I'm 23 years old and I can consent to that. And she just went over all the information and told me, you know, all the permanent changes and all the stuff that I needed to know, which I'll go over in a little bit. I didn't expect to get my prescription at that same appointment, but yeah, that same day after she gave me all the information, she, you know, I have a video, I'll link that in the description below of when I got my prescription. And yeah, so it was as simple as that for me. I mean, that's all I had to do. You know, I called them up, I made the appointment, I waited, I showed up, I talked with her. An hour and a half, 2 hours later, I had my prescription I didn't have it right there. She gave it to me and then I had to wait to pick it up. But yeah, so that's a more non-traditional way of doing it, but it is, you know, it's doable. When I was back in California, I did the traditional route, but I ended up, you know, being able to go this way. So, and then another one that is non-traditional and it's not really recommended, but you know, to each their own, you can go through Planned Parenthood. Now, I didn't do research on Planned Parenthood myself when I was looking into tea because I don't really think it, I never saw anything about Planned Parenthood when I was researching it when I was younger. So, but there's a few guys on YouTube right now that have gone through that process through Planned Parenthood. So I'll link their videos in the description below. Mad props to them and thank you to them too for, you know, putting that information out there because I was able to watch their videos and get some information off of there to make mine. So thank you guys. But yeah, definitely check those videos out if you guys feel like it. So basically, when you go the Planned Parenthood route, you talk to the doctor there and let them know that you want to start testosterone. And from what I gathered on YouTube, some people paid like $270 for the appointment and then $115 for the actual testosterone, and that's without insurance. But it varies, you know, that's just one person's pricing that they got. So one other guy paid $160 for the appointment and $267 total. So that extra was for the testosterone and stuff. But like I said, it varies for everybody. And I'm not sure if that second guy had insurance or not. I can't remember. The second guy, that's Devin Spears. I'll put his video in the description below too. Really cool dude. I love his videos. He's helped me out with a lot of information. Like, I've watched a lot of his videos and learned a lot. But yeah, so one thing that he did mention is that he tried to go through the LGBTQ hub in Florida and they recommended for him to go through 6 months of therapy for the T letter and then, you know, go the traditional route. But like I said, to each their own, everybody does it differently. And the good thing about Planned Parenthood is that you're still getting your lab work done. You know, you're still getting blood work, so you're able to keep track of your levels. You know, the one thing that you don't want to do is get testosterone illegally under the table anyhow. You know, like, make sure you do your research. It's very important that you do your research before putting something foreign into your body. You know, no matter how happy it's gonna make you, you want to make sure you're safe. So when you do the Planned Parenthood method, you go for your appointment and you tell them that you want to start testosterone. They do your blood work, they prescribe you the stuff, and then you come back later on and take your first shot. And then you return every 3 months to keep getting your labs done to make sure your levels are okay. Now, some of the permanent changes that they do mention is your voice altering, your clitoris growth, and then hair growth. So your facial hair, your body hair, and then male pattern baldness is something that is a possibility if it runs in your family. So keep that in mind. And then some of the reversible changes as well, if you were to stop taking testosterone, are a loss of muscle mass, decrease in sex drive, your acne is gonna, you know, go back to the way it was before. Not completely, but it will. And then your redistribution of your body fat that happens, it's gonna, you know, redistribute again. And then your menstrual cycle will come back. One of the risks with taking testosterone is infertility. There's some other ones. I didn't really do too much research on that because, I mean, there wasn't really much. Like, there's some other ones, but I didn't think they were worth mentioning in this video. But yeah, one of the big risks is infertility. But with that said, testosterone is not a form of birth control. So if you are female to male and you are taking testosterone, you can still get pregnant even if you don't have your menstrual cycle anymore. So if you're having sex with a person that has a penis and produces sperm, make sure that they're using a condom if you don't want to get pregnant, or you're using some sort of birth control because, you know, there's a possibility that you could still get pregnant. Here are the different forms of testosterone that you can take. So I got this from a guy named Sam on YouTube, most of this information, so I'll link that in the description below as well. Like I said, all these guys are really helpful, so check them out. Now, you can do injections, which is what I do. Intramuscular injections, which is the ones that I do. Now, I inject into my thigh. Some people inject into their belly, I think, and I think some people do their butt too, but I do my thighs. I switch off just every other week. I do a different thigh. And then there's subcutaneous. I don't think I'm saying that right, but there's subcutaneous. But yeah, it's 1 to 4 times a month you apply this under the skin. Injections are the least expensive and you see the quickest changes with the injections. The next form is transdermal. So there are patches. I believe there's androderm and testoderm. And these are applied every day at the same time. And, you know, pros of this is that there are no needles, and one of the cons is that it does take a little longer for the changes to come in. But, you know, if you don't like needles, this is a good way to go for you. But it is also more expensive. Another way of going about it is gel. Now, with the gel, it looks like there's, he said that there's Androgel and Testo gel. Now, that you apply 1 to 2 times daily, and when you're applying it any way other than shots, it's a little more stable. Your levels are going to be a little more stable. But yeah, so the gel is applied 1 to 2 times daily, but it is more expensive. The changes take a little longer to come in, and with the gel, it can be transferred to others, so you want to avoid skin-to-skin contact. Another one that I saw, which it hasn't been researched very much, so I don't recommend that you, like, try to go about getting on testosterone this way, because I really don't know anything about it other than what I found out, but it's pellets. So apparently, it's these pellets that are like little grains of sand, and they're crystallized forms of testosterone, and they're implanted in your hip or your butt, and they last up to 6 months. These are said to be just as effective, but they're less common and a lot newer, and it's more expensive. So, like I said, do your research. And then lastly, there's orally. So you can take a pill every day, and this will keep you at more stable levels, but it is bad for your liver to take a pill every day, and it is more expensive, and the results do also take a lot longer to come in. So one other thing is that I'm unsure if the pills are available in the US. I couldn't find anything on that. But yeah, so that's all the information on testosterone and how to get on it and things like that. If you have any other questions on that, please feel free to leave a comment or hit me up on Instagram. Now, my friend that hit me up asking about this, they also wanted to know about supplements. And there are a few supplements that I do recommend. I mean, I haven't really tried all of them, but I've done a lot of research. Between the ages of 21 and now 24, I've spent a lot of time watching a lot of videos about supplements and exercising and weight loss and hypertrophy training and just all kinds of stuff, you know, healthy eating and nutrition and all kinds of stuff. So I don't know everything, but these are just a few that I saw that I would recommend, and I did recommend to my friend. So some of these I do supplement with, but not all of them. My sister supplements with a lot more than I do, but and my sister looks great. I'll tag her in the description as well. My sister has lost a lot of weight. She's had 2 kids. She's a mother of 3 and a wife. She's a realtor, and she works very hard, but she also works very hard at the gym to stay at where she, at the fitness level that she's at. And she's actually the one that really inspired me to continue to work on myself, because I want to look as best as I can as the man that I am. And the best way for me to do that is to hit the gym as often as I can. And she's been able to inspire me to do that. So I'll tag her in the description below for you guys so that you guys can check her out. 4 of the supplements that I found that are great for you for muscle gain and weight loss. Before I get into that, actually, I do want to say that there is no like one supplement that will fix all of your problems weight-wise. Like, in order to lose a significant amount of weight, you have to be consistent with yourself. You have to be consistent with your eating, with going to the gym, drinking water, your sleep. It all has to be good. You have to take care of yourself, and that's the only way you're going to lose any type of weight or become any type of healthy. So yeah, some of the supplements are whey protein powder. Whey protein is efficiently absorbed by the body, and you know, you need protein in order to create muscle, to build muscle. You can't build muscle without protein, so whey protein's a really good one. And then creatine monohydrate, it's one of the cheapest and most studied, and that also helps build muscle. Another one is nitric oxide. Nitric oxide gives you a great pump during your workout, and it increases your energy, and it also allows for faster recovery in between sets. So those are some of the supplements that I found, you know, that are supposed to be really good for you and help you out with your journey in losing weight and gaining muscle. So try them out. If you do, let me know what you like about them. Again, if you have any questions or I can help with anything else, please feel free to reach out to me anytime. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'd really, really appreciate it if you do that for me. And don't forget to hit the notification bell when you do subscribe so that you don't miss out on any new videos. I'm putting out videos every week. It's been tough. I work 12-hour shifts, so it's kind of hard to make time to make these videos, especially because I make them all on my phone. You know, I record and edit and do everything on my phone, so it's a little tough, but I make sure to get them done because I like putting these videos out there for you guys. You know, I enjoy that I'm able to bring knowledge to you guys and that you guys are enjoying it as well. So I'll see you in the next one. Thank you, guys. Can you take your dog? Hi. Sorry. I've had a cold, so excuse me. But, damn it!